The Rhode Island Foundation is the state's only community foundation working with people to make a stronger Rhode Island. And now, two creative thinkers are being awarded as the winner of the 2013 Rhode Island Innovation Fellowship. And here to talk to us about it this morning, Neil Steinberg, CEO of the Rhode Island Foundation, and two winners of the annual program, Adrienne Gagnon and Lynn Taylor. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Great to have both of you here today. We're going to skip right over you just for 1 second.
It's fine.
Adrienne, we want to know, tell us about the idea that you came up with, because it's pretty amazing.
Thank you, absolutely. So the idea is that we're going to be creating more innovators for the state of Rhode Island by introducing the tools of design thinking to kids across the state. And design thinking is essentially just an approach to solving problems, any problem that a child might encounter at school or in life. We're helping them to become better communicators, better collaborators, better strategic thinkers and problem solvers.
And Lynn, your idea was?
So my idea is Rhode Island defeats Hep C. Hepatitis C is a highly prevalent unsolved problem in Rhode Island. We're disproportionately hit by this epidemic. So what we're going to do with Rhode Island defeats Hep C is develop a coordinated approach to this epidemic through a public arts awareness campaign, a screening program, a linkage to care, scaling up capacity and economic evaluation, developing a business model for Hep C.
And Neil, I understand 180 ideas or creative people were involved in this, but these are the two that were picked. Why were their ideas standouts?
Well, we got many great ideas, and we're very fortunate to have a lot of people thinking about Rhode Island. I think you can tell that both Lynn and Adrienne have passion and commitment and expertise and a real, real strong drive in their respective fields to have us make a better Rhode Island.
And the award is $300,000 over 3 years, correct?
Yes, correct. It really is with the support of philanthropists John and Letitia Carter. It was their vision to get Rhode Islanders to think about creative ways to solve and address Rhode Island issues, and that money is being used to seed these issues.
And now, ladies, how will, it's a lot of money, it is spread out over 3 years, how will you both put that money to use for your projects?
So a couple of things. The first thing for me is the arts awareness campaign. We're having a poster competition to raise awareness, being juried by Shepard Fairey, our favorite and very famous Rhode Island artist. I'll be seeing him in Manhattan Thursday. We're creating a wearable emblem to raise awareness and bring community and decrease stigma around Hep C that we'll be selling. And we're having a Hep C water fire next summer with Barnaby Evans' support. We're looking for sponsorship for that.
Nice plug. You're
and we'll be doing testing. We'll be spending money on Hep C testing kits. We have advances in technology and rapid testing kits. I'll be hiring a Hep C Navigator to work with me to expand testing and a lot of innovative and creative ways around our state. And we'll also be employing or consulting with two economists, mathematical modelers, to work on the economics of hepatitis C in Rhode Island.
Now this money, the $300,000, was given to you know, make Rhode Island a better place.
Right.
Some of the other ideas that came in, what will happen to those? Are they able to come back again? Are they able to resubmit?
Mm-hmm. Yes, this is the second year of the program, and this year we had several people who were repeat applicants. Many times because they had the chance to flesh out an idea, go off on their own and get support, and sometimes they will meet with each other and figure out ways to do it. But it really spurred a lot of ideas that go forward, even the people that aren't the winners.
Well, that's great, good stuff. $300,000, not bad at all. Thanks so much for coming in today. Great to have you here today.
Thanks so much for having us.
And to learn more about the Rhode Island Foundation, you can head to our website. It's the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.